roles. Previously, she was a dev advocate at Twitter and Facebook, and before that, an archaeologist. But that is ancient history. Coming out hot, ladies and gentlemen. How did you go from archaeology to all this other amazing stuff? Okay, hold on. Apparently, we're going to dig up the on button for Bear's mic.
Can we keep this up all night?
We're going to see.
Testing.
Are we good?
Testing.
Perfect.
Test louder. There we go. Okay.
I might just have to be louder.
I might just have to be a little louder. So I started learning coding in middle school. But when I got to college, I was distracted by all the cool stuff you could study, like econ and psych and archaeology and all the things. So I was undeclared until junior year, and then I got my act together quite quickly.
Well, there you go. All right. Everybody, one more time, Bear Douglas. Woo! One down, we have Jess Oso Rio. Everybody, give Jess a round of applause. Jess does integrated marketing at Mozilla, born in Colombia, raised in Florida, and moved to the Bay Area 3 years ago. Now she cannot get enough blue bottle coffee. Jess, what do you think you are going to bring to this trivia contest that none of your other competitors have?
Well, I work at Mozilla, where we are protecting everyone's internet, basically.
Gotcha.
So I'm hoping that gives me an upper hand. I have some knowledge you guys might not have.
There we go. Uh-oh. I like that confidence. And one down from her, we have Kyle O'Connor.
Hey, guys. Appreciate it. Thank you.
There we go. Kyle is a South African-born gaming industry veteran, having worked at IGN managing their social media team, who is now doing social media for Twitch. He's a support main in every game he plays and is obsessed with potatoes.
Yeah, that's really true.
Is that it?
Yeah. That's the perfect food.
What brings you such joy about the potato?
There's no potato that's not good. Like, every potato is great. If you hate potatoes, I really question
you as a
human.
What about those potatoes with the green spots?
What? I mean, that's like a... No, that's not. I'm not addressing that. That's slander.
Fake news?
Yeah, fake news. Oh, God. We're doing that already. Let's start out, come out swinging. Potatoes are great. Every form of potatoes are the best thing ever. Mashed potatoes, French fried potatoes, scalloped potatoes, tater tots, hash browns. Every potato is great.
Well, I'll tell you what. If this was a contest to name the amount of potato dishes we could, you would already be far in the lead.
Five.
Unfortunately, this is going to be about internet trivia, and we will begin our first round in a second. Here's how it's going to work. Round one will act like a quiz show where each of these panelists will compete against each other, buzzing in with their answers. In round two, we open up the trivia to all of you in a pub-style game where all of the audience members here and the commenters joining us online can play along and compete for prizes. In January, Mozilla released the very first Internet Health Report to document what's hurting, what's helping, the state of global public resource. The Internet is now its own environment and the natural habitat to some of the best and worst of us. How it works and whether it's healthy has a direct impact on our happiness, our privacy, our pocketbooks, our economies, and our democracies. All of the answers from round one can be found deep within that same Internet Health Report, which you can find at internethealthreport.org if you're playing at home, and we'll cover all the factors that make up for a healthy Internet: privacy and security, digital inclusion, decentralization, open innovation, and web literacy. So let's get started.
Yeah, web literacy. Woo!
Here we go. Starting at the very beginning of a website's URL, there are two things that you might see, either HTTP or HTTPS.
Well, that wasn't even a question.
It was her. It was totally her.
Wait, go on. I thought it was going
to
be.
No. How about this? How about this? What's the answer, huh?
Nope. I thought it was something else. Go on.
Unfortunately, nope. I thought it was something else. Please go on is incorrect, ladies and gentlemen.
The answer was yes.
Now, here's question number one.
No, I'm joking. I'm sorry. I'm just messing with you.
I wish I had a potato right now.
I'm hungry.
Sidearm it. Here we go. According to Firefox telemetry data and the folks at Let's Encrypt, we just passed a serious milestone in the amount of secure encrypted web pages happening on the web. So, to any site starting with HTTPS, what percentage of all page views are now secure? Is it A, 30%, B, 50%, or C, 75%?
30% A.
30% A. Incorrect.
Shit.
Did you have this? Did you also?
Wow, I'm going to go with 50%.
That is indeed correct.
Yeah, you nailed it.
It's good news. It's really good news.
1 point for Jess.
That is good news.
Here we go. Question number two.
You're welcome. Yeah, I took that.
The Dutch government canceling a countrywide birthday database didn't stop a media company called Setup from continuing to develop ideas that use publicly available data. Of those projects, which are real projects Setup is working on, and which one of the three that I am about to read is fake? All right, so what you're gonna do is find the fake project out of the three I'm about to read. Here's the first. A toaster that either toasts bread or burns it based on a person's social media reputation. A coffee maker that uses zip codes to determine how good a cup of coffee is to make. Or a refrigerator that can lock you out based on what you purchased at the grocery store. I believe that again, no, you want to know what? I'm going to go with Bear here. Bear?
It's the coffee. That's fake.
The coffee
yes. Is
fake. Unfortunately, that is real. That is indeed real.
That's awful.
Kyle.
Toast. The toast one.
That is also real.
So I'm right by default, right?
So here we go.
Second point for you.
Jess.
Do you remember the third?
That leaves a refrigerator that can lock you out based on what you purchased at the grocery store.
That one.
That one's fake. Hey, all right, everybody. Discretion being the better part of valor.
You're nailing this.
For Jess, let's move to number three. Name this Mattel doll, first introduced in 1959, which...
Barbie?
That is correct, Barbie! I'm going to read the rest of this just because it adds to the add-on question here. It caught flack last year when they released a new version that could connect to Wi-Fi, record what kids said, and compile those recordings into a database as well as talk back to them. So here we go. I'm going to ask you first and then open it up to everybody else if you don't get it. What is the name, the full name, of that Wi-Fi enabled recording talk back to the children Barbie? I will give you one hint.
Spy on me, Barbie.
It was that. It prompted protests on Twitter, hashtag hell no Barbie.
Hello Barbie.
Oh. Tell you what, Jess gets it. There we go. Unfortunately, spy on me Barbie, not the answer, but hello Barbie. Yes. I'll tell you what, I know everybody, you're chomping at the bit to get in on this. You're going to be in on the next round. So cool your pies real quick, all right? Here we go, number four. Moving on from last year's IoT controversy, Mattel has now developed an Alexa for babies. It's a smart baby monitor that can become an interactive talking toy and teacher as your baby grows into toddlerhood. This talking baby monitor shares the same name as a famous philosopher known for being Alexander the Great's childhood teacher. What is the Alexa for babies baby monitor called?
None of us. I've already failed spectacularly so far.
No penalty for a wrong answer here.
Just shame.
Just unmitigated shame showered directly on you by a gallery of strangers.
I'm gonna take a shot. I'm gonna take, who is Plato?
Plato! Incorrect.
Shit.
Incorrect. Yeah, it is pointed out here to the right of me that there is indeed already a children's toy named Plato.
Oh, yeah. No, I was confusing it.
All right, again, a famous philosopher known for being Alexander the Great's childhood teacher. Floor is open. Kyle, yet again.
Shot. Yeah. I don't know. I'm just going to go. I'm going through philosopher's shit. God, I'm sorry, guys. who is Socrates? I'm just going to keep going. I'm going to do it in jeopardy.
Show me Socrates. No Socrates. All right. Oh, one more.
Aristotle
is correct. Bear gets a point. All right, let's go ahead and move
on the board.
Into our first lightning round. This one's going to be pretty exciting here, folks. I know a lot of you guys are probably familiar with the television show Black Mirror. Anybody here seen the show Black Mirror? So I have a bunch of headlines that our panel is going to have to tell me whether or not they are real headlines or a plot from Black Mirror.
I'm just going to say real to everything.
Real headline or a plot from Black Mirror. So buzz in as soon as I read the headline. Here we go.
Buzz in when we hear the one that we think is fake.
No. Just for each one. For each one, we're going to go
just real or
one
fake.
By one. One by
got
one,
it,
real
it.
Black Mirror plot or reality. Here's our first one. Users skipping ads may face a financial penalty. Users skipping ads may face a financial penalty.
Oh.
I believe that was Kyle.
Real.
Incorrect.
Shit. I'm sorry. I'm going to stop cursing.
Incorrect.
Wait,
you really only have one more to go. So the first person to buzz in, not you.
Wait, I want you. Can I hear that again?
But I,
users. I mean, literally, one of you can buzz in.
Black Mirror plot twist.
There we go.
But I just binge watched the whole thing and I don't remember that. So what
this
was
is
it?
The episode 15 Million Merits.
The second one from season one,
where he's skipping the thing and then they talk
That's
at the thing.
Right.
I'm trying not to be a spoiler here for everybody.
I guess it just didn't feel like ads because it was so different.
But isn't this already kind of true? Like, you can pay not to see ads.
Oh.
Yes, but this is a penalty. You are
or you
to
could
be
use
debited.
Firefox.
Ooh. Yeah.
Sweet plug. Nailed it.
All right, here comes our second one, hands on buzzers. The headline is, big data-based ranking system gives all citizens a social credit score.
Black Mirror.
Incorrect.
True.
Yes.
Oh, we both.
I don't have zero.
I believe, so if it's a tie, we're going to give reality the edge, because there indeed was a Black Mirror plot that was similar to that, but this sounds a lot like the nosedive episode of BM, but this one is actually about a policy document released by the government in China that will compile a gigantic database in which it will list fiscal and government information with things like minor traffic violations affecting your score.
Wow.
Reality!
Yeah. Depressing.
Oh. Yeah, jeez. Really bringing the laughs here at the first HTTPS, ladies and gents. Here we go, hands on buzzers. Using a Wi-Fi network's name to broadcast a political message.
Real. Reality.
That is indeed correct. I don't really have a note on that one, so we're going to move on. I'm sorry, I can't connect to more Bush 04 here, so I guess I can't get the information. Here we go. Drone bees hacked for government surveillance.
Shoot. true.
Black Mirror plot twist.
That is correct.
I jumped the gun.
Jess, sorry, Kyle, no. That is indeed a Black Mirror plot. And here's our final one. Cartoon bear gains political traction. Yeah. Bear.
Black Mirror.
Well, of course you knew that one, right?
I did.
Cartoon bear gains political traction amongst disenchanted voters. That is a Black Mirror plot, which brings us to the end of reality or Black Mirror. Here we go. Question number 6. According to a recent study by Stanford University, even though we think of them as digital natives, some 82% of middle schoolers couldn't distinguish between an ad labeled sponsored content and a real news story on a website or in social media. Since source wasn't a factor for them in judging credibility, what did they think made the post credible? So this is open answer. I will award the person closest. In fact, you want to know what? We're just going to go right down the line here, and I will determine who got the closest to the answer. So
that's a lot of power.
We'll start with you, Kyle.
Shoot. Follower count. Is that
a follower count?
Yes.
Okay. All right. And I'll factor in popularity in general.
Yeah.
To that, Jess, what made middle schoolers think that something was more credible? Apparently, you can't just put ad or sponsored post above it, the little rapscallions. They got their other ways of determining how it's legit. What do they find to make it credible?
I'm going to go with the quality of the content. So the design factor, is it designed beautifully or is it just thrown together?
The quality of the design. Mm-hmm. Okay, all right. So we have popularity, design quality. Bear, what do you think?
I was thinking like the quality of the photo.
Well, too bad. No, she already got it.
Yeah, I know. So instead, I'm going to go with the number of likes it had.
The number of likes.
It's a good one.
Number of likes. According to our answer, we have two factors that these kids used. The first was the number of words. The longer the post, the more credible it was. So they are ready to elect President Lorem Ipsum.
Wow, that was a deep cut. That was a sick joke.
And I'm going to give Jess the point on this one.
Jess.
If a high-res photo was part of the post, so the design was well thought through. So there we go. One more point to, I mean, just dominant right now. Jess,
where do you work?
Mozilla.
Okay, just checking. Rigged.
It's not. It's so not. All right.
No need for sour grapes. You can still come back here, Kyle. Don't worry.
Super sour grapes.
Here's question number 7. While preteens might not be able to identify ads, hundreds of millions of people, presumably adults, are taking charge of their personal web experience by installing ad blockers. The Internet Health Report cited a survey HubSpot conducted back in July in the US, UK, Germany, and France, which was the top reason users gave for using an ad blocker. We've got 3 options here. Was it A, convenience, B, control, or C, security? Kyle.
Oh, control.
That is correct. Yay! Control.
So me.
You're gaining.
That's 2. 2 points for me.
So being in control of their online experience was indeed the winner, but convenience, not being disrupted by ads, and security ranked in the top 3. So those were the top 3 on the board. Here we go, question number 8. On the topic of control, unlike 2/3 of the countries on Earth, this global world power and technology-rich country has no comprehensive data protection laws enacted for its citizens. Name that G8 world power.
America.
Kyle. America. The United States of America! Woo! USA! 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 Yeah, it's not. That was the first.
That's bad. That was bad.
I don't know if that came over for the internet folks, but there was just like this immediate patriotism hangover. Yeah, where it's just like, oh, jeez.
If you chant anything, people die, join in.
By the way, not in Europe or Russia. Those countries all have comprehensive data laws. This country is one you might expect, but LOL. Here's number 9. Although it's always changing, there are 1.1 billion websites out there right now, this second, within plus or minus 5%. What percentage of all web domains are owned but just parked with no real owner website connected to them? I'm going to ask you for a 1 to 100% percentage of all of the websites that are just parked, that have no data on them. They are literally just parked. Of all the 1.1 billion that are out there, what percentage are literally just parked there? Maybe they just got a little sign with an under construction guy on it, but other than that, just parked, absolutely just parked, out of 100%, how many?
What?
Jess!
I thought we were all...
Okay.
Oh, yeah, we'll you want to know what? Here, no, we'll go.
Start over, right. Yeah.
We'll go, yeah. We'll go down the line here. Bear, what do you think?
$1.
$1.
1%, 1% for Bear, okay.
I'm going to go with 30%.
30% just part of the 1.1 billion that are in existence. Kyle?
I'm going to say 73%.
73%.
0.4.
0.4.
73.4, yeah.
I mean, no one's competing.
Here we go.
I'm competing.
With the 70.
Now, Bear, how do you feel? He went pretty high.
He went pretty high.
You think you might have overshot him?
I might have done.
All right.
I think.
What was your answer again, Kyle?
73.4.
The exact answer is 75%!
I did it. I knew it. I studied. I didn't.
Tell you what, I feel like this is a huge comeback.
Yeah, I know.
This is a massive wave
Super
of support.
Super Bowl of internet.
Gang.
Yeah, everyone in the chat right now is going nuts.
I know.
They're all just saying, Kyle.
All right, here we go. This brings us to another lightning round. Lightning round. You're going to buzz in when I say the following domain, and you are going to tell me whether it is functional or it is just parked. Functional or parked, buzz in for each one. Here we go. Domainsquatting.com. Fair.
Functional.
Incorrect.
Not functional.
Parked, yes! All right, here we go.
Thanks.
I just dropped the ball there on that one.
You'd think that they would have instructions on how to do it.
Here's the second one, hand on buzzers. Thank you for being a friend.com. Jess?
It is, what is it, live or not live?
it's parked or working? Is
it's
it parked
working.
Or
it's working?
Incorrect.
Oh, I got that one.
There you go.
It's not working.
It is parked,
indeed. Opposite of whatever she said, yeah.
Much like the Golden Girls series itself.
What? Oh, sick reference again.
Here we go. Bananaforscale.org.
Totally Bear. Real.
That is indeed working. Bear gets the point. All right, here we go. This one's cheese. All right. Do websites need to look exactly the same in every browser.com? That is Jess.
I'm going to go with it's working.
Working? You're goddamn right, it's working.
Except in IE6.
except in IE6?
That's my landing page.
All right.
Cross-browser compatibility, folks.
I'm going to spell this one out after I say it. Google.com.com, GOOGLEDOTCOM.com. Is it working or parts? Kyle!
It's working.
No, it ain't!
Shoot!
Yes!
Not working.
Oh.
Parts, yes!
This is rigged.
All right, here we go.
I'm just saying that so I can win in the end.
Sick reference.
Yeah, you nailed it.
Tightsarenotpants.com. Jess.
Working.
Yeah, it is working. And finally, http://fleek.af. Kyle.
That has to be real.
Indeed it is.
So
answers on Fleek from Kyle.
Yeah, sometimes.
Number 11. A small-scale survey in 5 countries cited in the Internet Health Report showed that users of this popular app either didn't know the app is on the internet or had no idea. Bear?
Facebook.
Yes! Facebook.
What?
They had no idea. Let me read the whole thing. A small-scale survey in 5 countries cited in the Internet Health Report showed that users of this popular app didn't know the app was on the internet or had no idea that the internet existed beyond Facebook. Because mobile phones have made the internet more accessible than ever before, 65% of Facebook users in Nigeria, 55% in India, and 5% in the U.S. didn't know that there was a World Wide Web outside of the walled garden of Facebook. What? Here we go, number 12. This is the world's second most spoken language among internet users, and yet it's only represented in 2% of all web pages. Name that language that so...
Chinese.
I'm gonna go ahead and, judges? Can you specify? Or can anyone
Mandarin?
Else specify?
Mandarin?
Mandarin Chinese, yes, that is it. Name the language that so many people speak, yet so few internet sites use. So the second most spoken language on the internet, and yet only 2% of all websites utilize it. Number 13. There are shining beacons of language inclusion out there, though, including the crowdsourced online encyclopedia Wikipedia, which continues to be a free font of knowledge to the tune of 16 billion page views a month in 284 languages. Which of the following languages is not included in that 284? This is a multiple choice. But Jess, do you want to call your shot? Or is that Bear?
Yeah. Esperanto.
Esperanto? No, it's not the answer. I assume it's... Who else is buzzing? Kyle!
Dothraki.
No! Well, then I'm just talking to you, Jess.
How about those multiple choices?
How about this? A, Upper Sorbonne. B, Picard. C, Quenya. Or D, Tetum. Jess?
I'm gonna guess D.
Tetum?
Yes.
No!
We all went?
I don't know how to say you don't get to buzz in again in Dothraki.
That's how you do it.
Is that it? No, go ahead and take a guess. Again, it was Upper Sorbonne, B, Picard, C, Quenya, or D, Tetum?
Quenya.
That is correct.
Woo! I knew it.
Judges, like, yeah, does he get a point?
I got one fan.
We'll allow it.
That's my girlfriend.
Quenya is, in fact, one of the elven languages from Middle Earth.
I knew that.
All right, here we go. We only have two more questions left in the first round.
What's the point disparity?
Do we know what the points are here?
There's no hope.
I got it.
Okay.
By how much? Oh, but I don't?
Yeah, Kyle.
There's only
Kyle's
2 points. Oh, that's cool. I'll win it.
Fourth quarter.
So it looks like this is really going to be between Jess and Bear here. Here's number 14. The European Union's copyright framework, written in the early 2000s, protects certain high-profile architecture.
The Eiffel Tower.
I think it's a different type of architecture.
You want to know what? I really feel like at this point, I'm starting to get suspicious of whether or not you
guys, read the Internet Health Report. It's right there.
You want to know what? I'm changing this. I'm changing this question on the fly.
Oh, it wasn't about
I'm changing this question on the fly.
I thought it was like Internet architecture.
Here we go. Here we go.
Oh.
All right. You're going to get 2 points for each of the three you can name. Okay?
What?
So it is correct that you need to name a famous European landmark that it is illegal to photograph and post online, though thousands do it every day due to standing copyright laws. So you want to know what? We're going to go down here. Don't buzz in. Eiffel Tower's one. You get a freebie because Jess is straight cheating.
Yeah.
But you can name. If you can name the other two, whoever can name the other two, y'all get 2 points, but you can get up to 6.
Hey, if I get 4 points, am I close to winning? Yeah. Oh, okay.
So that can put you in contention. Three
EU.
Of them that we have here.
EU. You said
okay.
EU.
And then one more.
But you said EU.
EU, yeah. Yeah.
Big Ben.
Okay. You don't know.
Wait, I thought we were going down the line.
We are. He just likes to ring himself.
I like the bell. It makes me feel good.
Yeah.
It's Pavlovian response. Buckingham Palace. I don't know. That's all I got.
Buckingham Palace and Big Ben.
Yeah, I went to London.
Maybe that's why they Brexited. all right. You read the report. Can you name the other two? No. Eiffel Tower is one of them.
The Arc, the Arc de Champs-Élysées.
The Arc for what?
Yes.
Arc de Triomphe.
That's where it is on Champs-Élysées. Okay. Yeah.
Okay. So that the one? Arc, the Arc.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm guessing that. And,
sure.
She's like, I'm guessing.
I don't know.
Any European
I
landmark.
I already guessed two. That those are my two.
Okay, that's fine. We'll leave the third blank. Bear. You're the one who can be within striking distance. You have the Eiffel Tower.
The Leaning Tower of Pisa.
Okay.
And can I duplicate any answers? Can I?
Sure, why not?
I'm going to plus one Big Ben.
Plus one Big Ben.
Yeah.
Well, y'all just get 2 points then. The three were the Eiffel Tower, the Little Mermaid in Copenhagen.
Oh, yeah, that was my other guess.
And the EU Parliament in Strasbourg.
Yeah, that was
so
my
there we
one.
Go.
Yeah, you guys get it.
Kyle apparently has become a folk hero to thousands.
Yeah, it's because I'm real dumb.
There we go, leading his own potato revolution.
We had a famine, now it's for a revolution.
Now you have a feast of success, thanks to Kyle.
Thanks, guys.
All right, here we go, final one. Final question here in round one. The digital revolution turned the music industry on its head. But now, streaming services are centralizing and consolidating power. Name this nonprofit, which developed a suite of free and open source online tools for musicians to market and sell their own music, and whose name is a word that
it.
You don't normally expect indie musicians to have a lot of. Jess, our leader in the clubhouse.
No. Wait, what was the last part of the question? That you don't expect the artist to have? What was that? The last
a
few words.
Whose name is a word you don't normally expect indie musicians to have a lot of.
Money. Sorry.
That was deep.
No, but I mean most music. Okay, I'm sorry, guys.
I thought it was SoundCloud, but I guess that's not it.
Okay, so we have money. We have fan base.
Yeah, because if you get too hip, you're not indie anymore.
It's a fair point. Fair point. And SoundCloud? Is that your final answer, Jess?
Way off, I guess.
We're all wrong. Let's do this again.
Do I have authority to go closest to the pin here? How many points is Kyle behind?
Yeah, make it happen!
10 points? No, two points.
I don't have 2 points, that's a lie. Oh, 2 points behind, yeah.
I am going to award
Dumbledore it.
2 points
yeah.
for this question. Kyle, what was your answer again?
Money!
It's cash!
Oh! Yeah!
Folk hero Kyle ties. So what now is our seven? And where's Bear at? Five. So five to Bear, seven each
yeah.
to Kyle and to Jess, which means I am going to use the first question of our round two as our tiebreaker.
We have answers over here, but I totally did not look at them.
Oh, my gosh.
So here we go. How many people around the globe, actually, here, do we have a pen? Do we have pens? I want them to have to write this down here. I don't want y'all to. In fact, Bear, sit in the center of that.
Wait,
sit
can we do this Final Jeopardy style? Can I wager some points? And
you can, sir, yes.
Oh, yeah, wager some points.
You can wager some points. All right, so here we go.
You need to wager some points on who you think is right.
I'm gonna give you guys all pens and paper here. All right? Just right there. Write how many points you have to wager. Again, both of you two here on the end have 7. Bear, you have 5.
I have nothing to lose.
You guys are tied. Bear apparently is all in. How many people around the globe are connected to the internet? How many people around the globe?
Is this one of these?
No, you're going to write it down, you're going to fold it up, and then we're going to reveal it.
Whew, I had a panic attack.
All right, how many people around the globe are connected to the internet? All right, folks. Can you feel the tension?
How many points did I have? 7?
You have 7. You can wager as many as you want.
Going all in.
Going all in.
Yeah.
It's all or nothing.
All or nothing.
For the internet's folk hero, Kyle.
Yeah.
All right. First, let's go to our third place contestant, Bear. You wagered everything. I immediately realized the fault of this wagering mechanic. You said 3 billion. 3 billion.
Bold claim.
All right.
Might be a little high.
Jess?
Okay, so I went with 3.5 to 3.8 because I've seen 2 different numbers cited today.
Yeah, right, when they made one. The questions.
Pick one.
Oh, no. No, I can't. I'm going to go 3.8.
Go 8.
I'm going to go with 3.6 if we have to pick
3.
Right in the middle.
3.6, and you wagered, guess what, all of
all
our
of
points.
Them.
Therefore, yeah, literally change your wager.
So, I get 3.25 billion, 7 points.
3.25 billion.
I'm sorry.
7 points. That means that the winner here, let me see that, you said 3.6, right? And you said 3 even. The winner is the person who gets it the closest. And since everybody bet all of their points,
I got it.
There was literally no point of doing the rest of this game. The correct answer.
I can't handle this.
Is 3.561 billion. Jess is the winner. So there we go, everybody. Let's get a big round of applause for all of our contestants here in round one. And we now move everything into our second round. I guess you guys are going to disperse. You guys can go ahead and find your tribe out here. Wait a minute. Hold on. Wait a minute. There is one thing that we do have to give out as everybody goes out there. I was handed the trash crown.
I'll take it.
For the person that had the lowest score.
Oh, I'll take it.
Oh, no.
We can split it.
Since everybody bet all of their points and therefore ended the round with zero except for Jess, who had 14, I will now give a privilege to the winner. Jess, who do you, of your two vanquished foes, who
this
gets the trash crown?
I'm volunteering.
Okay, if you're going to volunteer.
Yeah. I don't have feelings.
Because I didn't want to, you know, okay.
Just do it. Please. This is my moment.
There we go. The garbage king, the trash sovereign. One more round of applause for Kyle.
Thank you.
All right, now go have a good time. Go mix with your crews. I guess you could probably turn off. Are they gonna? Yeah,
don't turn
off
me
the
off.
Mics.
Okay. Cool.
All right.
Yes.
Perfect.
Is everybody in their groups of four that wants to play? Everybody in your groups of four that wants to play. Here's how this is gonna go. We are going to collect your answers every three questions so we can tabulate the scores. You have to be done with your three questions when we come around and collect them. If you are not ready, you will not get points for the entire set of three. So here we go. Kind of screwed things up since I we'll throw in an extra one at the end. Here we go. Does anybody not in a group? Anybody need more time? Are we good? Internet, are we good? Here we go. Here we go. If anybody ain't ready, then too bad. Here's our first question. The U.S. is in the lead for nations with the most internet hubs, with 97. What country is in second place for the most internet hubs? Again, the U.S. is in the lead for the nation with the most internet hubs, with 97. What country is in second place for most internet hubs? Looking for second place. Second place. If you see somebody up on their phone trying to figure out this answer, shame them. All right, here's the second question. In 1992, Sir Tim Berners-Lee uploaded the first image to the World Wide Web. It was a photograph of an all-female comedy band, four women in formal gowns who work their day jobs in the nuclear research lab at CERN. What was the female comedy band's name, literally the first band on the internet? What was the name of the band in the first photo uploaded to the internet? We're looking. This one's just for the real nerds. You're going to have to dig deep into that neck beard to find that answer. Name of the band in the first photo uploaded to the internet. Name of the band. And by the way, here's a bonus question. Bonus question alongside of that. A former member of this band, Colette Marks-Nielsen, told Vice magazine that Sir Tim Berners-Lee had his own moonlighting interest, which involved also music and fancy dresses. What did Tim Berners-Lee like to do in his free time when he wasn't inventing the internet? That's a little bonus question. This is part of number two. Part of number two. Bonus to part of number two. I will read that again. A member of the band that is featured in the first uploaded picture to the internet, Colette Marks-Nielsen, told Vice magazine that World Wide Web inventor Sir Tim Berners-Lee had his own moonlighting interest, which also involved music and fancy dresses. What did Tim Berners-Lee like to do in his free time when he wasn't inventing the internet? That again is a bonus answer to number two. And here's question number three. Today, 25 years after Sir Berners-Lee posted that first image, around 2 billion, with a B, images are uploaded every day. There are websites totally devoted to images, like Imgur, which shows a feed of current viral images sorted by popularity. What animal is Imgur's mascot, an animal which gets its name from the Arabic fast walker? What is the animal mascot of the website Imgur? And an extra credit to that, what two accessories does this mascot wear? What two accessories does the Imgur mascot wear? We are going to give you guys 1 minute to finish up. We've got our crack team here grabbing your answer sheets. Again, question number three. 25 years after Sir Berners-Lee posted the first image, around 2 billion images are uploaded every day. There are websites totally devoted to images like Imgur, which show a feed of current viral images sorted by popularity. What animal is Imgur's mascot, an animal that gets its name from the Arabic fast walker? And for extra credit, what two accessories does this Imgur mascot wear? Looking for the two accessories that the Imgur mascot wears. All right, go ahead and get everybody raise their sheets. If it has not been picked up, it will be picked up. You're going to use a fresh sheet for the next three. But first, we reveal the answers. Is everybody in? Everybody's got their sheets in? Cool, right? All right. Here we go. The U.S. is in the lead for nations with the most internet hubs with 97. What country is in second place? We're all done? We're all collected? Anybody not collected? All right, here we go. Second place, Brazil is in second place. The super weird band that was the first picture on the internet, Les Horribles Cernettes. Apparently somebody got it. And what did Sir Tim Berners-Lee like to do in his free time, according to a member of Les Horribles Cernettes, Colette Marks-Nielsen? Well, he liked masquerading in drag and singing in an amateur operatic society. Sounds like a good time. And number three, what animal is Imgur's mascot? Well, that would be a giraffe. And what accessories does that mascot wear? Well, but of course, a monocle and a top hat. Monocle and a top hat. All right, here we go. This one is multiple choice, multiple choice, multiple choice. So I'm going to read off three possible answers. You give me the one that's correct. This is question number four. In 2013, the most searched query in Google that started with what is ended with what subject people desperately needed more information on. Was it A, what is love? Was it B, what is twerking? Or was it C, what is gluten? Again, was it A, what is love? B, what is twerking? Or C, what is gluten? This is the 2013 most search what is query on the Google. All right. Go ahead and get that one down. This is question number five. All right, you guys are going to want to listen to this one. You're going to rank the following social networks in order of users from most used to least used. All right, rank the following social networks from highest number of users to lowest number of users. The following social networks are what you're going to rank. Facebook, Snapchat, Qzone, Instagram, and Tumblr. So write them down and then jumble them around. I'm going to give you that list one more time in no particular order. Facebook, Snapchat, Qzone, Instagram, and Tumblr. Rank those from number one to number five. Highest to lowest. Again, Facebook, Snapchat, Qzone, Instagram, and Tumblr. All right. Here we go. This is question number six. Question number six. Here we go. Question number six. Who was the most famous MySpacer of all time? Famous MySpacer of all time. And for a bonus, who was the second most famous MySpacer of all time? First and then second. Second's a bonus. I guess we should technically say as of now. MySpace is still around, right? All right. One more time. Here are the three questions. Number four, in 2013, the most searched query in Google that started with what is, ended with what word. Was it A, what is love, B, what is twerking, or C, what is gluten? Question number five, Rank the following social networks in order of users from highest to lowest. In no particular order, those are Facebook, Snapchat, Qzone, Instagram, and Tumblr. And number six, who is the most famous MySpacer of all time? With the bonus, who was the second most famous MySpacer of all time? Go ahead and raise your sheet. When you are done, you are officially 1 minute away from us reading the answers. So get your answers in right now. Get your answers in right now. All right, 30 seconds, get your answers in. Get your answers in. We got them all? If you don't have them in, you better raise them right now because I'm going to read the answers. Here we go. 2013, the most searched query in Google that started with what is, ended with what word? That is B. What is twerking? I mean, listen, folks, you know it when you see it, I'll guarantee you. Rank the following social networks in order from highest to lowest. Number one, Facebook. Number two, Qzone. Number three, Tumblr. Number four, Instagram. And number five, Snapchat. Snapchat, pulling up the rear. This is an easy one. This is a gimme, folks. Who was your OG top eight friend? Well, that would, of course, be Tom. Tom from MySpace. But who was the second most famous MySpacer? Well, that would be the now fairly infamous Tila Tequila. I am sure that her top eight is full of some very colorful characters these days. All right, here we go. MySpace is still working. And you can Google Tila Tequila if you want to find out the rest. I am going to defer on that one. All right, here we go. Question number seven. This tech company released an AI chatbot to see if it could maintain human conversations on Twitter. With the help of some comedians behind the scenes, the chatbot started out sounding like a hip young millennial girl, but things devolved as it quickly learned in less than 24 hours from the Twitter community how to tweet like a horrifying racist troll. Which company made this chatbot-tastrophe, which turned into a racist Twitter troll within 24 hours? Again, we are looking for the name of the company that made the AI chatbot that started out sounding like a millennial young lady and ended up sounding like Tila Tequila. And extra credit if you can name the name of said chatbot. What was that chatbot's name? Oh, she started out so innocent for about 5 minutes. Again, the company that made the chatbot, and extra credit if you can give us the name. And double extra credit. Double extra credit. Another extra credit. In fact, you all, we're going to make this the next question. It's not extra credit. It is indeed question number 8. Though it may seem surprising that AI chatbots like the one that we just mentioned fall into the darkest depths of human communication in less than a day, there is a name for this phenomenon. What law, quote unquote, states that, and this is right from the definition, as an online discussion gets longer and longer, the probability of a comparison to Nazis or Hitler approaches certainty, end quote. That is, all online discussions will eventually include the words Nazi or Hitler, according to what law? This law, by the way, became an official entry in the 3rd edition of the Oxford Dictionary in 2012. Again, we are looking for the law that states, as an online discussion gets longer and longer, the probability of a comparison to Nazis or Hitler approaches certainty. Question number 9. When he first began as a contractor for the NSA, Edward Snowden was employed by what famous computer company? What was Edward Snowden's day job when he first became a contractor for the NSA? Famous computer company that Edward Snowden was drawing a check off of when he first got a side gig at the NSA. So one more time, we are looking for the company that created a chatbot that went from sweet young millennial girl to racist troll on Twitter. For extra credit, give us the name of that chatbot. We are looking for the law that says any online discussion will eventually include Nazis or Hitler. And we are looking for Edward Snowden's day job before he got a gig consulting for the NSA. You have 1 minute. Raise your answers when you are finished. Seconds. Does anybody have answers yet to be put in? Anybody? We got them? Here are your answers. What was the company that made the Twitter AI chatbot that devolved from millennial girl to racist troll within 24 hours? Well, that would be Microsoft. Microsoft. And what was the chatbot's name? Tay. Like, oh my God. What is the law that says as an online discussion gets longer and longer, the probability of a comparison to Nazis or Hitler approaches certainty? That, of course, would be Godwin's Law. Godwin's Law. And what was Edward Snowden's day job when he first became a contractor for the NSA? Dude, he was getting a check from Dell. Working at Dell Computers. Dell computers. Are we close to getting a points check? Another one? All right. Here we go. Question 10. This is multiple choice. Who coined the word meme? Who invented the word meme? Was it Christopher Poole? Was it Richard Dawkins? Was it Tim Wu? Or was it Tim Berners-Lee? Again, who coined the word meme? Was it Christopher Poole, Richard Dawkins, Tim Wu, and the rest of the Wu-Tang Clan? Or Tim Berners-Lee? Looking for the man who coined the word meme. Question 11. In Star Wars, A New Hope, Princess Leia pleads for Obi-Wan to help in their struggle against the Empire in a holographic message played by R2-D2. What security protocol must have allowed R2-D2 to carry his message without the Empire accessing or deciphering it? We are looking for the security protocol that would have allowed R2-D2 to carry his message without the Empire accessing or deciphering it. It is a security protocol so important that it was even around a long time ago in a galaxy far, far away. What security protocol must have been used on R2-D2? And question 12. In 2012, what company had 6.5 million user passwords hacked and leaked? Again, in 2012, what company had 6.5 million user passwords hacked and leaked? All right, here we go. As you guys figure that out, let's go ahead to our scoreboard here. All right. Here we go. Make some noise when I call your name. At Hotmail. Where's at Hotmail? At Hotmail? They're there. Oh, there we go. Very polite. At Hotmail. At Hotmail has 6 points. Chillzilla is our leader with 7 points. The Commodore Pets have 5 points. Team Carne Estrada has 2 points. The LOL Cats have 3 points. A team that has apparently changed their team's name each round, yet we are calling out of spite, official use only. Oh, wait, I'm sorry. I lied to Chillzilla. They are in second place. Official use only is in first place with 9 points. And stick to one name, you smart Alex. Derpa has 6 points. Liz is awesome has 3 points. And Eye Patch Cat has 6. Now, those are only through 3 rounds. So we have the round that we were just asking questions about and our final round to go. A tight, tight, tight race here. All right, everybody, 30 seconds. If you have not turned in your last round, do it now. Do it now. Do it now. 30 seconds. All right. Does anybody not have theirs in? We got them all in? Here we go. Who coined the word meme? That is Richard Dawkins. Richard Dawkins. Dawkins conceived the cultural meme as a cultural analog to the genetic gene, as they both self-replicate, mutate, and respond to selective pressures. A meme is a unit for carrying cultural ideas, symbols, and practices that can be transmitted from one mind to another. What security protocol?
Host Alan Combs has died. He's best known for being the liberal voice on the talk show Hannity and Combs that ran for 12 years on the Fox News Channel. A spokesperson says he died this morning after a brief illness. Combs was 66 years old. He's a native of New York City and worked for years in radio and stand-up comedy before joining Fox News in 1996.
Hello, CPAC!
What company had 6.5 million user passwords hacked and leaked? LinkedIn. LinkedIn is the answer. LinkedIn. And I'm sure they were excited to email you about it, like they are everything else. All right, folks. We have only 3 questions left. And based on the scores we just read, that means that over half of our teams are still in this. Here we go, question 13. Merriam-Webster just added 1,000 words to their dictionary, including words like ghosting as a verb, to throw shade, photobomb, and net neutrality. But who was the first to coin the phrase net neutrality? Hint, it was in his book, Attention Merchants. Who invented the phrase net neutrality? No. Good guess. Yes, the author name. Who wrote the book Attention Merchants, which included the first coining of the phrase net neutrality, which was just added to the Merriam-Webster dictionary? All right. 14. What was the most retweeted celebrity tweet of 2016? Was it either Harry Styles from One Direction with his tweet, "I don't know about you, but I'm feeling 22. Was it Hillary Clinton? "To all the little girls watching, never doubt that you are valuable and powerful and deserving of every chance and opportunity in the world." Or was it Rubio5, a YouTuber from Madrid, who simply wrote "limonada" with an emoji that looks like an Easter Island head? So again, one of the three here. Harry Styles from One Direction. I don't know about you, but I'm feeling 22. Was it Hillary Clinton? To all the little girls watching, never doubt that you are valuable and powerful and deserving of every chance and opportunity in the world. Or was it Rubiu5, a YouTuber from Madrid, who wrote Limonada with an emoji of an Easter Island head? One of those three, the most retweeted celebrity tweet of 2016. And our final question of the evening. In November 2016, a malware program called Mirai mobilized 100,000 connected devices, including webcams and baby monitors, in a DDoS attack that took down parts of the internet. What does DDoS stand for? What does the acronym DDoS stand for? DDoS, a DDoS attack. What does DDoS stand for? All right. Here are the questions one more time. Who coined the phrase net neutrality in his book, Attention Merchants? Who was the most retweeted celebrity tweet of 2016? Harry Styles from One Direction saying, I don't know about you, but I'm feeling 22. Hillary Clinton, who said to all the little girls watching, never doubt that you are valuable and powerful and deserving of every chance and opportunity in the world. Or Rubiu5, a YouTuber from Madrid, who simply wrote, in all caps, Limonada, with an emoji of an Easter Island head. And number 15, in November of 2016, a malware program called Mirai mobilized 100,000 connected devices, including webcams and baby monitors, in a DDoS attack that took down parts of the internet. What does DDoS stand for? DDoS, DDoS. What does that acronym stand for? Everybody go ahead and lift your sheets. While you guys get in your answers, let's go ahead and take a look at our prizes. Our third place team will all receive pizza gift certificates. Or rather, you will all be dining on pizza thanks to a pizza gift certificate. Pachi's Pizza. Our second place team will get this combo of shirts with a cat on the screen of a laptop. Pushy, and the Boss Babes coloring book with, there we go, featuring Boss Babes, including but not limited to Beyonce, Ruth Bader Ginsburg, and Malala. And our first place team. Oh, hold on. Wait, let's get it. Let's unfurl it. A Zero Fox Given t-shirt. Show the world exactly where you stand now that you demonstrate that you have zero fox given. As well as a cup symbolizing your victory. Hoist it above your head like the Hyrule heroes you are. This is a Legend of Zelda collectible Link Pintglass. That goes to the first place team. Third place gets pizza. Second place gets the shirt and the Boss Babes coloring book. And our first place team, again, a Zero Fox Given and Zelda Pint Glass for everybody on the team. Are we ready? We have a tie. I'm sure we can figure it out. Well, here, all right. Let's run down our. Oh, tie for third. So y'all can split some pizza. I don't know, man. Whatever. Figure it out amongst yourself. All right, hold on. Here we go. Our answers for our final three questions. Who invented the phrase net neutrality in his book, The Attention Merchants? That would be Tim Wu. What was the most retweeted celebrity tweet of 2016? That would be Rubio5, the YouTuber from Madrid, who wrote Limonada. The Limonada tweet was retweeted 4.1 million times in reference to Beyoncé dropping what should have been a Grammy Award winning album, Lemonade. And what does DDoS stand for? That, of course, would be Distributed Denial of Service Attack. Distributed Denial of Service Attack. All right, I want our co-third place team, each team, send up a representative or all come up here if you want. You're going to have to shake hands as what we are now going to refer to as the Pizza Accords. Let's get a representative from Team Derpa.
Boo this man!
Team Derpa, all right. Come here, you're going to be on this side. And Team Commodore Pets. Commodore Pets. Come on up, Team Commodore Pets. Oh, Team Derpa. Team Derpa's got a mascot. All right, here we go. Commodore Pets, come on over here. Come on over here. I'm gonna hold your beer, sir, because you guys have to shake hands for the Pizza Accords. There we go, ladies and gentlemen. And who said we can't get along in our modern age? Congratulations. One more round of applause for Team Derpa and Team Commodore Pets. All right. Our second place team. They get the coloring book. They get the t-shirts. They are Team iPatchCat! Come on up, everybody, on Team iPatchCat. All right. Here we go. I'm going to need a drum roll. Our first place team is Official Use Only! There we go. Come on up. Go ahead and grab your t-shirts. Grab your... I'm sure you and your team are enthralled with the victory you have earned. Let's get one more round of applause for Official Use Only. If you could sum up your all of your excitement in a one-word victory cry, what would that one-word victory cry be?
Yeah, actually, it may
encryption! One more round of applause, official. You so lame. They are the winners of the first ever HTTPS. Thank you guys so much. Is there anything else that we need to go over, right? Are we good? All right, everybody. Mozilla, thanks everybody for coming out. Give yourselves a round of applause one more time. Let's go ahead and get a big round of applause to everybody who helped organize this event. Let's keep it going for the tech crew that actually organized and made this thing continue to go well. And for everybody that is watching live online, thank you for joining us. My name is Justin Robert Young. For everybody else here at Mozilla, thank you guys so much. Good night!
Rising to the top, don't stop. See?